Now, it's something I think everybody knows what a sales funnel is. Why don't you take maybe 30 seconds and just give everybody a quick definition of what you picture this step and a sales funnel to actually be?
No, that makes sense. Everyone tends to know what a sales page is. You go there and someone sells you something. Everyone knows the importance of building a database. So you go to the, I don't know, homepage of your website, and there's a form where someone can fill it out and they get a free something of value. So, for example, it might be a sample chapter of your book in exchange for their thing of value, which is their email address, and then you're allowed legally, because they once they opt in, to market to them at this address. And that's kind of how it traditionally works. It's not enough anymore, and it hasn't been for a long time. So how a sales funnel works is that this address you've got, which traditionally you might have sent out a monthly newsletter or something, and that, in my opinion, does jack all, you've now got the right to use that email address in a range of different ways. Not just that, but when they came to that page, that sales page, whether or they bought or not, and not everyone buys first time around, and depending on the price point, not everyone you send buys anyway, you're losing those people if they're not signing up for the free thing, and if they are and you're not contacting them, you're losing them as well. So how the sales funnel works is that that very first page of that sales funnel is probably not selling something. Or if it is, it's selling something of a very cheap value. I refer to that as the preview. When you sell something, I refer to that as the package. So what are you packaging together? It might be the printed book and the ebook for a discounted price, your primary product you plan to sell to someone. And there's another step within any single sales funnel, and I refer to that as promote. Here's what my definition of a sales funnel is. They come to that first landing page, they give you their email address, and then they're automatically redirected to the package. They do or don't buy, you don't care, because they're in your database. If they do buy, they're handled differently to the people that don't buy, but they're still in your database. When they buy, because you've now got all the marketing happening in the background, so you don't need to do anything, their landing page from purchasing your product is, would you like to promote the product, become an affiliate, things like that. That's the three-step sales funnel I recommend. But when I talk about sales funnels, that's not even what I'm talking about. I'm talking about how to take these three steps further. So lead gen, traditionally, that was flowing people into that very first page, that free offer of your very first sales funnel. But when you've got affiliates coming out the other end, they can actually do that for you. Now, that's cool. Let's say you sell a $20 book and affiliates do it for you, so you no longer need to do any lead gen. That's great, but you're selling a $20 book. How can we leverage the content of that book so that you're selling more? Maybe you want to turn the content of the book into an online course. Now you can send the affiliates out of, instead of back to the $20 book, maybe into the $2,000 course. And then a sales funnel is a completely different thing, because it's not a single page with a free offer. It might be your sideways sales letter, where they sign up for a free week of video training and they get sent a different video every day, which could go for anything to up to half an hour, to build relationship with your prospective customer before you even try to sell them anything. There's so much in this sales funnel space, as you can probably hear.
Yeah, exactly. And you did mention the book a little bit. So talk just briefly about how a book fits in and where it might fit in for someone's sales funnel at this point.
Yeah, good question. I generally think it's the start point. The book these days should definitely be referred to as the new and improved business card. And I mean two things by that. Firstly, that the old style business card no longer works. If I ever rock up anywhere physically these days, which is seldom happens, but I won't take business cards with me because I don't believe in them. But the book is the new and improved business card. So much more space to fit in, for example, time to build a relationship with your prospective market, as well as for calls to action, which of course is the most important thing. And unlike a business card, the call to action isn't a phone number where they can utilize your time, or an email address even where they can be talking to you that way, or even a physical address for those people that still send snail mail. But what it is it's a space for you to send them to that very first page of your very first sales funnel. So for me, from the back of the book, I would be going to something like the course, for example, because the book already has been purchased. But the first page I would send them to from anywhere else, so any other lead gen technique, would be that free preview of the book. And what that is up to you. Traditionally, it was a sample chapter. I don't find that works so well these days. That may not replace with a free ebook. That's all well and good, but why are they going to buy it if they got the free one? Well, a good technique could be, here's my free ebook. They're in your database. The page they're redirected to the next stage of your funnel is, would you also like to get a physical copy for those of you that like to hold a physical copy in your hand? Okay, here's how much it costs me to print and post. You can have it at cost. Then you're not out of pocket. You're still running the process cash flow positive for your marketing. Another technique can be to skip the free preview altogether in this instance and go, no, I just want them to come for such a good offer that they purchase my book so I can move them to the next stage from there. And that works well as well. And some people don't even sell the book anymore. They might, for example, have the lead magnet that someone comes for their online course. They might only be interested in an online course, but they're using the book to profile them into that fully virtual space. They might use it as a lead magnet. Now, I just told you a suggestion where they were going to get a week's video training. Some people don't sign up for the video training. They get converted when they receive it. So the lead magnet is get a free copy of my book, such and such, and I'm also going to give you a free preview of my program delivered to your inbox over the next week. And that I'm actually finding is one of the most popular at the moment.
Yeah, I mean, it makes sense. I mean, people want value, and if you're giving them value and value not only that they can perceive, but they can go and implement, they're going to want to come back for more. And you know, there was a lot, folks, you're going to have to go back and watch the replay because Kylie just gave you a whole lot of information. One of the things I want to try and do is simplify it just a little bit. If you picture a sales funnel just like a funnel, what you're trying to do is get the looky-loos and the casual people. You want to get all of them at first and then funnel it down to your real clients. And that's where a book really helps out because if you write a book on a topic that everybody wants to hear about and a core problem that you can solve, you're going to get a lot of people at that big end of the sales funnel, a lot of looky-loos, so to speak, a lot of people who will never buy, never engage with you at all, but at least will learn about your service. And then as you work them through the funnel, as you give them more and more content, people are going to drop off. People are going to go by the wayside, and there's going to be less and less people funneling down through. And the beautiful part is that just as in a funnel, the most important things come through first, and then everything else stays on top. So it could be that those people might come to you after a while, or they might not. It might be like when you're pouring the Kool-Aid drink mix down the funnel and actually have a little water on. You know how it gets stuck to the side and only some of it comes through? Well, that's okay. The good stuff got through. I mean, you know, does that kind of all make sense? Does that all fit in with what you're talking about and make sense, Kylie?
That's actually a really good analogy. I must admit, I often take some of that stuff for granted. I always talk at high level with everything I do. So I must admit, I probably didn't make it basic enough for people. So I do apologize for that. But that's a really great analogy. What I'll add to it is that the reason I was talking the high end and the way I teach funnels is we don't want any residue left. We want every single person to drift through. So think of a funnel more like a sieve. Okay, the funnel's got one point at the end, but with the sieve, they're dropping out at different points to different things. Hey, they only want the free version, that's okay. They go from the free version of the book, for example, to the free version of maybe the membership program, to the free version of maybe a trial coaching session with you, by which stage you can convert them one-on-one at that point.
Right,
Some
exactly.
people also purchase the product. They might purchase a $20 book, then maybe a $200 membership program, and then maybe a $2,000 coaching package. I like to teach to add a naught. So what you said was brilliant, but I always like to take stuff to the next level. Put them through the sieve as opposed to the funnel.
There you go. And that I think is a good place for us to move on into marketing tools. Now, raise your hand if you could use more clients. Now, keep those hands up if you know that the best, most efficient, most effective way to attract your ideal client is to create great client attracting content that connects with your ideal client and makes it easier for you to convert them into paying clients. Now, whether you have your hands up or have your hands down, I invite you to join me on the Create, Connect, and Convert Online Summit. It's where I and other people who are real world practitioners of creating great client attracting content are going to share our secrets with you. The summit is online. It runs Wednesday, April 13th through Saturday, April 23rd. You need to go out to the web address on your screen at this point, register to reserve your seat. And remember, you want to join us on the Create, Connect, and Convert Online Summit because creating content is how you spread your message, reach more people, and make a bigger difference. To watch the rest of this epic episode now, click on the link below the video. Do it now. You'll be glad you did. Are you still here? What are you waiting for? Watch the rest of this epic episode now by clicking on the link below the video.